function is reusable code where we want to apply the same code to different inputs. This saves you from having to write the same code again and again, where you only need to change the inputs, but the functionality or the code is the same. We discussed using pre-built functions in R, but have not yet discussed creating your own custom function in R if you're required to for your own particular need. In our video on controlled statements, we used the for, if, and else statements to tag our data as high or low met income and store those tags in a new column vector so that we can add this to our income data frame. But what if in future we are working with different data frames and we create new columns that we would like to add to those data frames? We will be working with many different data sets, so it's likely we will want to apply the same functionality onto any data frame and column vector. So what we need to do is create a function for this. So here's an example of what that function would look like. Most functions require a name of some sort, and they also require some kind of inputs, some kind of processing of those inputs, and usually return some kind of output after having processed the inputs. This is the basic makeup of most functions. So we first give our function a name and call, so we can use this to call the function later, like we did in the pre-built functions video. We called the readCSV function by its name, readCSV, and then gave it the required inputs. In our function here, we have called it addVectDF, and we will use its name later when we're ready to call the function or use it. We also specify that it's a function that we're creating here with the given inputs of a data frame and a vector, which can be named anything by the user, but df and vect take the place of the user's data frame name and the vector name. We call the functions, when calling the functions, the user of our function will need to first input the name of their data frame and then the name of their column vector. The core functionality is that we use rcbind here to basically add the vector onto a data frame and tie it to a variable called newDF. And then we return newDF or the resulting data frame after having added a new column onto the data frame. So now if we call this function after running our function created above, so we'll run this. And we call it, so we use the name to call it. And give it the required inputs. So our data frame is income and our column vector is income level. We run this, you'll see it's done what it's supposed to do. It's added this column onto our data frame. So now using this function, we can give it any required inputs, so any data frame and any new column vector we wish to add. So we don't have to rewrite this code or hard code this each time we want to, you know, apply this function to a different data frame and vector. And that completes our introduction to R series. You're now ready to hit the ground running the first day of the bootcamp. But remember, any new skill requires some practice. So revise these learning exercises if you need, and we look forward to building up your data science skills.